It's Atlanta's only hip-hop station, Hot 107.9 and home for the Ricky Smiley Morning Show. You're kicking it with your phone behind. Radio shouting, man. I got somebody stepping in this thing, man. He might tell you. It's a green light, but it's money, man.
Green light.
Allen Ball, what's happening with it, boss?
Man, working, big dog. You know how we doing it.
Already, I mean, tell me about the movement, man. I mean, that Negro 90, it hit the streets and started raising cane, man. Tell me about it.
That was the whole purpose for it.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? Like, to just, you know, turn up. That, you know, I brought that thing out in November.
That's right.
You know, and you know, it was just, you know, rough some feathers.
Yes, sir.
Showing what time it is, showing what it's gonna be, do what it's gonna be. You know what I'm saying? It's a real demanding mixtape, so
already
what it is.
Now, I mean, when I first popped the tape in, I mean, I go straight to the intro, because I'm gonna take it from top to bottom.
Exactly.
I mean, I'm hearing Black Panthers, I'm hearing Malcolm X, and I say, hold up now.
Yeah.
This boy Allen about to educate these folks.
Oh, that Angela Davis, we bring it in. You know what I'm saying? Then I got a skit from Malcolm right after that. You know what I'm saying? That's how I just wanted to pop it off, man. The whole and Negro Night, and I feel like, you know, I'm finna put it out there for what it is. You know what I'm saying? This for our kind. This for where we at. You know what I'm saying? So I'm trying to make this whole thing like a movement, man. It ain't just a mixtape, you know?
It's
me. It's personal, you know?
Now, question. I mean, when I listen to your music, I can see the difference from everybody else's stuff, because I'm listening to it and I'm saying, this guy is talking about exactly what's going on. I'm hearing folks talking about what's happening, but I mean, from a street level, I'm hearing it and I'm like, this dude knows eyeball on the street. What's happening?
I'm down.
Yeah.
I ain't just watching. You know what I'm saying? I'm in the mix. You know what I'm saying? My family in the mix. All my partners in the mix. We out here. So I know exactly what's going on. I ain't glorifying the up parts of the streets. You know what I'm saying? I'm telling you what it is. You know what
I'm saying? Now, what makes you rather keep it real than go for the commercial hip hop? You know, blinging and all this extra stuff shining and, you know.
It's easy for me to be me, you know what I'm saying, and concentrate on what I'm doing and keep my thing going, because, you know, when I try to go in and be something I ain't or whatever, it makes it hard for me to record. So when I go in and just be me and talk about what's going on around me, it's that much easier. I don't have to never change up. So I feel like as long as I'm doing me, and if I can pop my whole situation off of me being me, I'm always be comfortable, and I'm always be able to, you know, win.
Now, off that Negro 90, man, I mean, what are some of your favorite joints on that? I talked to my boy K the other day. K was like, hey, man, I heard that I'm guilty, man. He said that man spoke straight to me on that thing, man.
I'm a man, Jody.
Yeah.
Eastside Jody, he right here.
Already.
You know, that who on out with me, you know.
Okay, what's happening with it, homie?
That's a record I wrote while I was locked up. You know, I had a little run-in, and I got out in November with them. That one of the only records, like, I wrote a lot of hooks, but that's one of the only ones that I just wrote the whole lyrics and everything to, you know what I'm saying? It's just a real song, you know. I have stuff going on in my life, you know, and I just try to speak from it, you know what I'm saying? And it turned out, it was crazy. I got out, my little dude, Lanil, he hit me with the track.
Right.
They were like, man, it's it.
Now, from the time being locked up to the time you hit the streets, I mean, what was on your mind when you were locked down and you were like, I got to keep this movement going, man, and I'm over here on pause?
You know, like, I violated my probation, like, the end of 09. And I had been on a run all the way until October last year, you know what I'm saying? So people didn't know, you know what I'm saying? But I wasn't doing no shows in Atlanta then, you know what I'm saying? So I had a lot on my head, man, you know what I'm saying? It was a real setback for me, but I still, you know what I'm saying, try to keep my music going and keep it pushing or whatever. And when I got locked up, I didn't really know what was going to happen to me, you know what I'm saying? Like, really, God blessed me, you know? And I ended up getting a probation bond. You know, I'm out on a probation bond.
Mm-hmm.
So they gave me a bond until I finished everything that I got going on.
Mm-hmm.
And so, you know, the whole time I was in, I ain't know they were gonna bless me like this. So,
yeah.
I mean, I lost weight and everything. I was in there stressing.
Get out of here.
Yeah. Like, I was smaller than me when I got out.
Yeah.
You know, and I just had on my head, like, done, man, you know. Like, I just was praying, like, man, if I get this chance again, I gotta get out, and I ain't holding back nothing. You know what I'm saying? So that's where the whole Negro Night came from, you know what I'm saying? So that's where the world already.
Now, you hit the ground running when you came out, man. I mean, how did it feel to be able to hit the ground and start turning up like that?
man, it's always a blessing. It just really you know, when you're in jail, you have a lot of time to think. And then, so I was just at a point, like, just thinking to myself, I'm watching the whole game, I'm watching the whole rap scene in Atlanta, everything that's going on. I'm like, man, you know, they ain't gonna give me nothing.
Yeah.
You know,
yeah.
So I gotta take me.
I'm
in a taking situation, and I always felt like I keep it real all the way around. Like, I'm gonna keep it real all the way around, but they say, okay, you can't come with the same mentality from the streets to this. But I'm like, okay, in the streets, you know, I hustle, but majority I took. You know what I'm saying? So I'm like, I gotta really go back to what I know, but do it in a legit way. I gotta do it with this, but I gotta take my position. You know what I'm saying? So I'm in a taking, you know what I'm saying, frame of mind right now.
Now, speaking about that, I mean, we hear it in the music. I want in. Tell me about it, man. Because I know it's hell. I already know it's hell.
You know, the whole record, man, it was like me, you know what I'm saying? Like, I ain't gonna cut no corners, man. You know what I'm saying? It was what it was, and people know what time it is. You know what I'm saying? Like, I said what I said, and I meant it. You know what I'm saying? It was some situation that happened between, you know, them two cats or whatever. You know, I ain't into promote no dudes or whatever they name and junk or whatever, but people know what it is. So, it was some situation that happened with the boy Tilt or whatever, and about a video that was put out on him from one of our artists or whatever. I don't want to get too deep into that, but anyway, he called my big homie, one of the other CEOs, you know what I'm saying? He called him and he threw something out there to him, like a certain proposition about what happened.
Yeah.
And it made me look at a dude like a coward, you know what I'm saying? Like, you gotta stand up for yourself. Can't nobody, you know, fight your battles, you know what I'm saying? So it really, like, brushed us real sour, like, you know, and, you know, instead of just taking it to the streets, you know what I'm saying, which we was about to, but it was like, okay, I'ma just, you know, I'ma go this way. And with the other dude or whatever, you know, it's just a character thing. You know, people be like, oh, Allie, you just did a song with him or whatever, he was on your song or whatever. But I'm like, you know, it done been a lot of females that I liked from the jump, you know, and until I got to know him, you know, I got around him and just seen their characters, and you know, hey, we ain't in no marriage or whatever. I ain't committed to being cool with a person,
right?
You know what I'm saying? But in a way, no middle finger to both of them.
Yeah.
That's my word. That's what it is, you know? So, hey.
Now, my question is this now. I mean, there's a lot of folks out there that say, Allie run around here raising hell, whooping the ass, and taking that. Question, is it a method to the madness, or is that just what it is?
That's what it is, man. You know, like, ain't no room for the weak. I ain't never respected weak, period. I don't like a weak woman. Oh, name weak, you know what I'm saying? It's raw, you know what I'm saying? So that's what it gonna be with me, and that's what dudes gotta know. But I ain't, you know, the whole duck tape vibe, whatever. Trying to be on no bully, nothing or whatever, because like both of them dudes, you know what I'm saying, I was a fan at one point, you know what I'm saying, like they cool, like it was cool, but when you show me the same, you know, characteristics or whatever that I don't agree with, I ain't the one to bite my tongue, you know what I'm saying. And you know, I know people got fans or whatever, and they like, they don't really see the inside. They don't know the inside stories. All they know is the music that would be put out there, and they see the videos or whatever. But you know, it is what it is, man. And it was a chance I took, you know. But I'm always keep it real, man. You know, and it ain't never from a hater point of view, because I ain't got nothing to hate about. You know what I'm saying? But real is real, and fake is fake. You know, and you know, spade is a spade. So that's what I'm at with.
What's next for Allie, man?
Man, we going hard.
Tell everybody.
Turn up.
Already.
You know, I got the Negro Nada, man. It's smashing right now. You know, I got the I Say joint. You know, Atlantic, they standing behind me 1,000,000%. You know what I'm saying? They know I got all my little legal situations and stuff out the way. So they like, it's time to go. You know what I'm saying? Like 2012, like I said, man, I'm taking it. I'm taking it. I ain't asking for it. I'm taking it. You know, this is how we doing it.
What do you got to say for the folks that come from the same areas that you come from, and they trying to do the same thing? Either they want to rap, or they just want to get out their current situation and do something positive and turn up. What kind of advice and wisdom you got?
I just feel like, you know, that's for everybody. Like, you see all the people down on Wall Street, you know, they you know, they boycotted it, and folks, they want in. Everybody, like, it messed up out here. Everybody sick of the fake. You know what I'm saying? So you just got to keep it real with yourself, man, and keep pushing, man, and just, you know, quit asking. Take your way. Do you. You know, don't ask about it. You know, we going to ask questions later, man. We going to strike first.
That's right.
You know, and just do your thing, man, because it's a messed up time right now, and it's time for some real, time for some new, you know. We in a whole another tax bracket from the upper class or whatever. So we got to put some type of movement together for us.
That's,
you know,
right,
what I'm saying? The way we can move in a unit, mm-hmm, you know, and keep moving and build our situation up. You know what I'm saying? Because that's what they doing. Mm-hmm. You know, that's the whole reason for the whole New United thing. You know, I took it upon, I'm like, okay, everybody like this, the Illuminati out here or whatever, that group or whatever, mm-hmm, and they supposed to be high-powered people, and they somewhere, you know, sacrificing family members or whatever. So I'm like, we're going to put our thing together. We're going to start this Negro Night.
That's right.
We're going to keep pushing, you know what I'm saying,
right,
and do our thing, link up as a unit, mm-hmm, and keep pushing, you know?
Mm-hmm. Allen Boy, appreciate you coming through this thing, my dog. Already, man.
Man.
Wish you nothing but the best and much success, homie.
Man, thank you, man.
Man, this B-High Radio, shout at Allen Boy, Hot 107.9, man. Let's get it.
Chill.